Welcome back to the channel, guys. It's your boy B.O.B. Bob in the building. How y'all doing today, my doubly family? Welcome to another edition of Shady Sunday. We here for this today. So DJ, let them know who we got up on the stage. Shout out to my comment section. You guys have been requesting this one. Haven't heard it, so this is gonna be my first time you and I checking this out. I'm kind of mad because I low-key wanted to listen to this song so bad because of the reviews I was hearing about it, but I waited until the channel. And now that I'm looking at this video, I see this video has 1 million likes. I have seen videos, millions of views on videos, but there are many rare music videos that I've seen that have 1 million likes. So, Eminem, Higher, this will be checking out today. So no long talking, no delay, DJ. Shady needs no introduction. The GOAT needs no red carpet rollouts on this channel. Y'all know how it go. This your first time here, it don't take nothing to smash that little subscribe button. Drop a like, leave a comment. Welcome to the channel, guys. Let's get into this today. Bust a move. Run the track, DJ.
Yeah. You know, I've been around for a while now.
All right. I done hear the beat and see what's going on. My boy lifting weights in the gym. This sound like we got another workout song. This sound like this one can get listed in my gym mix.
Not sure if I have much left to prove. Yeah, I do. I look at me now, I'm thinking, damn, how proud of me I am. What I did is nothing to sneeze at, even if your allergies are bad. I'm up in the balcony in France.
Sneeze at, allergies are bad, you know ain't no need to break that down.
I look around, I see the fans, how they surround me in the stands. Probably could drown in a sea of hands, they're hollering, Shady,
yelling. Hold on, this beat is wicked. I gotta go back, let's start this over one time again, Shady. Hold on, let's start this back, let's go.
Me now, I'm thinking, damn, how proud of me I am. What I did is nothing to sneeze at, even if your allergies are bad. I'm up in the balcony in France. I look around, I see the fans, how they surround me in the stands. Probably could drown in a sea of hands, they're hollering, Shady, yelling it out to me. And that's what I mean when I say that one day, some way, somehow, if I get the chance to get a crowd, I flip it around and have a crowd give me the chance.
Woo! I love that flip. If I had a crowd, one day I wish I could have a chance to have a crowd. Now I'd flip it and have the crowd give me a chance. They hollering Shady. And then he said, Steins, Fines, but from the Marshall Mathers LP came out, Eminem's Fines have been known as Steins since then. So we kind of seeing the crowd is in the Steins, but he's saying Steins instead of Steins, like when you go to concert, people who sitting in the different rows. Let's go, Shady.
I've done it all, man. But in actuality, I haven't yet. Where am I supposed to go from here?
Okay. Let's go back. This beat is crazy.
Out to me, and that's what I mean when I say that one day, some way, somehow, if I get the chance to get a crowd, I flip it around and have a crowd give me the chance. I've done it all, man. But in actuality, I haven't yet. Where am I supposed to go from here? Okay.
That also, that whole verse was a flip. I think off of Shady's concert that he did in France. If I'm not mistaken, I think that was the year 2013, 2014 that he did the concert. Where he was like, you know, he was in France. All of his stands were out. Saying he could get lost in a sea of fines. All that? Yeah.
But in actuality, I haven't yet. Where am I supposed to go from here? Okay. Really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling.
Woo! This chorus can get you amped up. This chorus can get you amped. Basically, he's just saying in that whole chorus, in my perspective, like, you know, you ask yourself these rhetorical questions sometimes, like, because he's hit that ceiling. Or he's been at his peak so many points on so many different albums. Like at one point in time, maybe might have thought his peak was the Marshall Mathers LP. Didn't think that he crushed that ceiling, went through to another level. So it's like he were asking himself these rhetorical questions, like, where am I going with this rap shit? But at the end of the day, Shady said long time ago, I'ma rap until I'm fossil fuel. Meaning he gonna be doing this rap shit until he can't do it no more.
Got no time for no haters in this bitch. Or toleration for the shit, but like medication, my dedication in the time it takes to do this shit.
Ooh, got no toleration for this. Like medication, dedication, it takes time for it to work. Because, you know, medication does take time for it to activate, but he's saying he ain't got no time for haters and the whole flip. No time, but it takes time. Let's go, Shady.
Bitch, well, toleration for the shit, but like medication, my dedication and the time it takes to do this shit reminds me of how an overcrowded hospital waiting room again. What I mean is maybe I have more patience than I'm able to admit.
That is crazy. That is fire. Overcrowded hospitals, too many patients, but he's saying he don't have the patience. But crowded hospital, basically, a doctor sees a patient. Those are the people that are in the waiting room. And, come on, Slim Shady. This song is fire so far. And I'm only a minute and 12 in.
That hospital waiting room again. What I mean is maybe I have more patience than I'm able to admit. Yeah, but I'm still mentally stable. There's a three-legged table in this bitch. Fame was a switch, but I was grateful to trade this shit for the trailer with a hitch. That it would make me a raving lunatic. But I made it through my situation. I hit pay dirt. Now I get paper like a...
Hold on. I missed something just now. Hold on, Shady. I missed something.
Get table in this bitch. Fame was a switch, but I was grateful to trade this shit for the trailer with a hitch. That it would make me a raving...
Grateful for the chance that he got on to actually get, because you know in 8 Mile he used to live in a trailer park, and trailers basically hitch onto the back of a truck, the little piece in the back. So he's like, he's just thankful and grateful always for this chance that he had to get on, because he was able to leave that trailer and that hitch behind. Let's go.
Able in this bitch. Fame was a switch, but I was grateful to trade this shit for the trailer with a hitch. That it would make me a raving lunatic. But I made it through my situation. I hit pay dirt. Now I get paper like a stapler in this bitch. But just cause I...
Staple of paper. Ain't no need to even break that down. Cause you know...
But I made it through my situation. I hit pay dirt. Now I get paper like a stapler in this bitch. But just cause I made a little bit of change don't mean I've changed a little bit. Brain full of wit, dangerous. Can't extinguish this English language when it's lit. Now...
Eminem is so good at flipping words, bro. Eminem is so good at flipping words, and it is so simple, but how he does it is like, how do you even think about that, bro? How did you even think about that? Change a little bit, but now I made a little bit of change. People will say the whole flip right there, a little bit of change, same words, but then like the sentence has two different meanings. Eminem is so sick of doing that, bro. Words are so dangerous that extinguisher can't even extinguish him when he's getting so lit. Come on, Slim Shady.
I've changed, don't mean I've changed a little bit. Brain full of wit, dangerous, can't extinguish this English language when it's lit. And I'm just berating you with it. It's shady till I'm 82. I spit this crazy, even Dre, he knows I'm a blow. Better get the handkerchief again.
Nose, blow. Even Dr. Dre knows that I was gonna blow anyway. I was gonna become huge at the end of the day. Nose, but... K-N-O-W-S, but nose, blow, handkerchief, which you blow into. You just say you're going to rap till he's 82. I ain't going to tell no lie. I still think 82-year-old Eminem would be fire. Because these other dudes out here, if they keep doing this, I mean, Shady put in another 20 more years work. I'm happy with that.
Maybe to us, spit this crazy, even Dre, he knows I'm a blow. Better get the handkerchief again.
So where am I supposed to go from here? Oh, hey. Really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been.
You know I'm talking about this shit a lot.
Where am I supposed to go from here? Oh, hey. Really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been.
If we learn anything from watching 8 Mile is that when it comes to battle rap, don't come for Eminem.
Facts.
He will be the first to tell you that he treats the rap game the same way the world's best athletes treat their respective sport, with a 24/7 tenacity that only the elite are able to channel. He spent his entire life studying and training to be the best, but even with a life of preparation, will it be enough for his next battle? It's one thing to conquer your competition. It's another to conquer your demons. With us now to share his thoughts is Dana White, who knows a thing or two about marquee battles. Dana, thanks for being with us.
Everything he said is so factual, so factual.
How prepared can one be when going up against an opponent of this magnitude?
Yeah, thanks for having me. Listen, I'm a huge Eminem fan, but this is a tough one. This opponent is not someone you can prepare for. It's a tricky demon to conquer, even for someone as badass as Eminem. My prediction, is disappointment for fans all over the world.
That's interesting. We are now joined by the man himself, Eminem.
I tell people all the time, when you go up against an artist like Eminem, sit down and think very carefully about what you are about to do, because you're going at somebody who ain't like nobody else out there in this game. The Michael Jordans of the basketball world, the people who live, eat, and breathe the game, the Kobe Bryants, that's who Eminem is in the music world. Put some respect on this guy's name.
Eminem, I appreciate it. What's your response to what...
Look at my boy.
Dana just said.
I want
to... weird beard. Don't mind MGK talking shit.
I say, first of all, thank you for having me on. I think that people like you give people like me the fuel that they need to succeed in the first place. So I think that the best part about your opinion is that it doesn't matter. And if every fighter that you had listened to your opinion when you doubted them, you wouldn't have a f-ing league. So you're an a-hole and I'm out.
Hey, I'm not gonna tell no lies. Somewhere deep down in Slim Shady, he has always had a part comedian to him. In every video Shady has done, from the real Slim Shady, Without Me, there's always just that aura of him where he can literally be funny when he wants to. He did it in Godzilla. All the little things he does here and there, the little roles that he plays. Eminem has a comedic side to him that I don't think a lot of people recognize. And for me, especially, I love the petty. I love the fact that of who he is when it comes to music in general. But even those little witty stuff like that, the comedic little, you know, animation and humor. Man, I'm such a big fan of that with Eminem. I am such a big fan of that.
Well, he definitely sounds ready. In any case, it should be a battle for the ages. Thank you, Dana, and best of luck.
I'm still laughing.
To you, Eminem.
That shit was so funny. I'm sorry, guys. Let's get back to the music.
Now, what am I gonna do? Ain't nothing, homie, I'm on the loose. Born a winner, never so hard to lose. I can do it even when I'm trying to. With my record flop, I still go through the roof. This atmosphere is for a
hold on, I know I missed something just now. Hold on.
Up to you, Eminem.
Now, what am I gonna do? Ain't nothing, homie, I'm on the loose. Born a winner, never so hard to lose. I can do it even when I'm trying to. With my record flop, I still go through the roof.
When my record flop, it still goes through the roof. He talking about revival. Even though technically Revival was his worst sales album, when Revival dropped, still made the Billboard in its first week, 1.1 million in sales. The facts are there. Whoever wants to quote me on it, go ahead, pull up your stats. I'm here. I want the smoke. I want the smoke on top of smoke, underneath smoke, wrapped around smoke, served with smoke. Bring it.
This atmosphere is for a chosen few who was on their grind making money moves. And you ain't gonna get there if you watered down. You gotta take shots, check 100 proof.
Been in survival mode.
Ooh. Watered down, you gotta take shots 100 proof. Now, I'm not sure if that's just an alcohol reference. 100 proof is basically rum that is real, real alcohol. And probably there ain't much rum out here that is 100% proof. But that's the good stuff. That's the real good stuff. Also, that could be a playoff of his, one of M's best friend, rest in peace, Proof, who was a part of D12. If you guys... That could be one of the two. I don't know which one it is. It might be just the alcohol reference, watered down shot, 100 proof. Definitely means that the shot is not watered down if it's 100% proof. Let's go.
And you ain't gonna get there if you watered down. You gotta take shots, check 100 proof.
Been in survival mode. Since a 5-year-old, it was I alone. Since my trike was stole's viral notebook and microphone. But looking back how bad it was then, if it hadn't have been for the pad and the pen addict, mom and dad beat dad, I wouldn't have had the savage within, having to win every single battle I'm in.
He talking about his past. Eminem has made reference to his addictive mom and deadbeat dad in many, many songs. Cleaning Out My Closet. He did a whole song just on it. He always makes reference to thank God for music for taking him out of the life that he was in. Back in the day, nothing with a spiral notebook. Y'all know the spiral notebooks. With a microphone. He said if it wasn't for that and all the other stuff that he been through, I always tell people, your past does not determine your future. Your past just makes you to be the person who you want to be, to make your own future or to fulfill whatever you want to do. Your struggles, your trials become your testimony. And that's literally what Eminem is talking about right now. Like, he always is telling about how he grew up, all these trials he's been through. This is why he is the beast he is today. And he's saying it clearly here. If it had not been for these stuff, he might not be the savage that he is today.
All I ever wanted was to be an MC. Tediously, I wrote obediently, believing in me. EPMD must have had teaching degrees, learned to defeat enemy.
Shout out to EPMD, Eric Sherman, the Green Eye Bandit, PMD. Two fire group back in the day. Those of you who watched the Versus Bar with Redman and the Method Man, you would have caught EPMD on that. Redman used to run with them back in the day.
MC tediously, I wrote obediently, believing in me.
This is why Reggie is on Eminem's list. If you wonder why I dropped 80 bars, that's why I dropped the 80 bars. Because you know, if you go on Eminem's Twitter, Eminem doesn't post about many artists. But he posted about that Redman.
EPMD must have had teaching degrees, learned to defeat enemies with the ink, thinking of these rhymes would be as easy as E, and graffiti would be like remedial reading to me.
He always shouting out people, man. He always giving the greats their roses. Eazy-E, EPMD, shout out to Eazy-E, member of the NWA, the whole line where he's thinking of these rhymes could be as easy as E. Come on.
The ink thinking of these rhymes would be as easy as E, and graffiti would be like remedial reading to me. To my last breath, these my lungs, I'ma beat my drum for the.
That's Conor McGregor.
Graffiti would be like remedial reading to me. To my last breath, these my lungs, I'ma beat my drum for the streets I'm from. The east side slums, gotta remind them, I'll take a foe out like feet by bum. You see my biggie.
Oh, that is. Ooh. Thank God I was paying attention to the lyrics just now, not the video. Ooh, that is the hardest bar I've heard in this whole line. I haven't heard something that fire so long. And it's so simple. I told you, Eminem comes up with the simplest shit, and you'll be sitting there like, why hasn't somebody else thought of that before? I take a foe out. A foe is basically the enemy. Your person, whoever, your competition, whoever your competition is, that's your foe. That's your enemy. I take the foe out of fee, fi, fum. But the original Jack the Beanstalk's line is fee, fi, fo, fum. So he took the fo out and just left fee, fi, fo. Slim Shady. Slim Shady. You won't call. Ooh. Ooh, if I had a punching bag in my host right now. I ready to go to the gym. I ready to go to the gym. 100 push-ups tonight, son.
You see my.
I gotta let that rhyme play out again. That was so hard.
It would be like remedial reading to me. To my last breath, these my lungs, I'ma beat my drum for the streets I'm from. The east side slums, gotta remind them, I'll take a foe out like feet by bum. You see my finger, you see my thumb, you see my fist for a least pipe. I'm here for the smoke, but it's not the.
I do this all the time. You see my finger, you see my thumb. Cowabunga, you know, Hawaii, aloha. Basically, another way of greeting, saying hi. Like how some people say peace, deuces.
Feet by bum, you see my finger, you see my thumb, you see my fist for a peace pipe. I'm here for the smoke, but it's not the weed I want. With this beat I brung for the beef I've come, but you better bring it if you want to reclap from. Cause for you to be lyrically inclined, it'd be a steep climb up. That'll be an uphill battle, but I'm up like your feet in a recliner. And I think I'm about to go out on a limb like a tree climber. Time to push my.
The wordplay. This be like an uphill climb. Be a limb off a tree. Come on, Shady. You killing these boys.
Feet in a recliner. And I think I'm about to go out on a limb like a tree climber. Time to push my ceiling higher. Cause
where am I supposed to go from here? Okay. Really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been. Where am I supposed to go from here? Okay. Really, I have no idea.
I ready to go to the gym now. I ready to go to the gym, and if anybody tests me right now and want to go in a sparring one-on-one, we could go in a sparring one-on-one. Ooh, that was fire. I see why you guys wanted me to check this out. Yeah, this is going in my list. This is listed in my Serato, in my personal workout playlist. I'm actually gonna do my own gym mix to this, because I do gym mixes all the time and drop them on my SoundCloud page. If you guys want to check that out, I'll drop the link in the description. Listen, I'm adding this. I'm glad you guys wanted me to check this out, man. Thank y'all for this, guys. Truly appreciate y'all. Peace, health, and wealth. Stay faithful, always be grateful. Peace out.